Hi, I'm Steve Carstensen. Do you want a quick tool to use in your practice to identify patients at risk for sleep disordered breathing? How would you like a tool that's over 90% specific for a patient who might be at risk for sleep disordered breathing that you can do in a few minutes and create a completely different encounter experience for your patient in your practice? StopBang is what you want to use. There's four questions to begin with. Stop. Do you snore loudly, or has anybody told you that you snore? Are you more tired in the daytime than you think you should be? So in other words, people who are sleeping 3 hours a night, they should be tired, but people who are trying to get plenty of sleep, they're more tired than they should be. Has anybody observed you stopping breathing? And do you have high blood pressure, or are you being treated for high blood pressure? You could just do four questions. And if they get two of those questions positive, then they're at high risk for sleep apnea, like an 80% specificity. Add four more questions to really make a difference. Is your body mass index more than 35? Now, this is a pretty heavy person, but how do you calculate body mass index? You have to know how tall they are, but you have to know how much they weigh. So you have to have a scale in your office because people don't know how much they weigh or they won't tell you. So you have to have a scale. That's a new experience for that patient in your office. Is your age more than 50 years? Is your neck circumference greater than 40 centimeters or 17 inches in a man, 15 inches in a woman? I know that calculates a little differently, but you can kind of use it that way. And that means you have to have one of those little tapes you can measure neck sizes with. Another new experience for a patient in your dental office. And are you a male gender? So if they get out of eight questions, four or more questions positive, they have that 90% plus specificity for some form of sleep disorder breathing. Now, what else goes along with this is you've given them a whole new set of questions to answer that they've never answered before in your practice. You've touched them with a neck circumference scale. You've weighed them. So they're going to talk about that. They'll go home and they'll think that's a new experience. They'll go home and tell their family members about that. They'll go back to work and talk about what their dentist is asking them about. And you'll be able to help them connect a positive response off a StopBang survey with a very important medical diagnosis called obstructive sleep apnea or airway problems while they sleep. So it's another whole thing to learn about, but using StopBang in your practice is a quick way to get that done. You can learn more about this or download a StopBang questionnaire at adaceonline.org.